Assalamu alaikum beloved students, welcome to the class of biology. And today in this video we'll continue with our practice questions of the chapter Why do we fall ill. So let's begin that, but before starting today's lecture we'll continue with the recap of the previous questions. So the question which we have seen, that is MCQ, and in that we have seen different kind of diseases. Then nextly we have seen short answer type question, in that we have given two examples of each kind of disease. And the diseases are acute disease, chronic disease, infectious and non-infectious disease. So in this we have seen what is acute, chronic, infectious and non-infectious disease. Then after we have seen these blanks, in which we have seen the target organs by the following disease. So here hepatitis targets your liver, fits and unconsciousness targets brain, pneumonia target lung, and fungal disease targets skin. Then after we have classified the given disease as infectious or non-infectious disease, so you can go with that. And to answer this question you should know what is the meaning of infectious and non-infectious disease. Then after we have seen some long answer questions, in which we have started with giving reasons. So the first is balanced diet is necessary for maintaining healthy body. So why is it necessary? For that we have provided 4 points, that food is necessary for the growth and development of the body. Then after we have provided that the balanced diet will provide us materials like energy, then many other material, protein, carbs, fat, minerals, etc. Then next question, why do some children fall ill more frequently than others living in the same locality? So here we have provided 3 to 4 reasons behind that, that maybe they are having weak immune system, and then we have provided the reason behind their weak immune system. Then next we have seen is precautions will you take to justify prevention is better than cure. We have provided 4 precautions for this. Now let's begin with today new questions. So the questions are, what are the sources of iodine? So here you have to provide all the sources of iodine. So that are, the best source of iodine are seafoods and cod liver oil. A smaller amount of iodine occurs in milk, leafy veggies and cereals. And iodized salt contains sufficient amount of iodine. So these are the sources of iodine. Maybe they can ask you in 1 mark or 2 mark. It depends on it, right? Name the disease caused by the following: protozoa, virus, bacteria and fungi. Then they have asked another question in the same, how is malaria transmitted? So first you will answer this all, that how you have to name the disease caused by this all, protozoa, virus, bacteria and fungi. And then after you will answer this question, how is malaria transmitted? So let's begin with that. First we will name all the diseases which are caused by this all. So by protozoa, here they have given the disease. Then by virus, AIDS, polio, dengue, chicken pox, etc. by bacteria, pneumonia, tuberculosis. Now see, it depends on the marks, that in how many marks they are asking, and according to that you will name it, right? You will give the name, but you will remember all the names as you have to write 2 to 3 or 4 also. Then fungi mainly causes the skin disease and food poisoning. So we have answered that first question. Now we have to answer the next question, that how malaria transmitted. So we know that malaria is caused by a parasite found in female Anopheles mosquito. So first we will mention this, that we found by it caused by a parasite which found in female Anopheles mosquito. Then we will mention that how will it cause transmission. So when the mosquitoes carrying the malaria parasite bite a person, the parasite will enter to that particular person's bloodstream and the person suffers from the malaria. So to answer this question, this both the points are necessary. You will mention the name of that where you can found or its parasite, and then you will mention that how will it transfer from that mosquito to the healthy person. Okay, next question: why should we always cover our nose while sneezing? Now answer of this question already we have discussed. Simply they have changed the type, the format of the question, that why should we always cover our nose while sneezing. Now we know that microbes present in our lungs and respiratory tracts can spread through tiny droplets thrown out during sneezing. So while we sneeze, that all the stuff can be thrown out during the sneezing in the form of tiny droplets. And anyone standing close by can inhale air containing those droplets and get infected. Therefore, we should always cover our nose while sneezing. And this is a very healthy habit for yourself also and for healthy society also. The next is, what is immunity? So you can answer it, that immunity is the ability of the body to defend against a disease. It is the ability of our body that it can defend against a disease. What is the method of transmission of the disease cholera? So you have to explain, you have to write that is by contaminated water. Now we have seen immunity. Now let us see, why is it necessary? Why is immune system essential for our health? So the immune system of our body is a defense mechanism to fight against the pathogenic microbes. It has cells that are specialized to kill infecting microbes and to keep our body healthy. So hence, as powerful our immune system is, that much healthy we can stay. Means your immunity must be higher to stay healthy. So if the body's immune system is strong, it can easily fight with that microbes and will keep us healthy. Okay, so here you can provide these two points, that what is immune system, and then we can explain that how will it fight for us. Then next, What are the two basic principles of prevention of infectious disease? So the two basic principles of prevention of infectious disease are prevention from exposure to infectious microbes and provision of proper nutrition to keep the immune system in a healthy state. यानी जो इन्फेक्शियस डिसीज है उसका प्रिवेंशन के उसके प्रिवेंशन के लिए कौन से बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स है. सो फर्स्ट इज जो इन्फेक्शियस प्रिवेंशन फ्रॉम एक्सपोजर टू इन्फेक्शियस माइक्रो एंड द अनदर इज प्रोविजन ऑफ प्रॉपर न्यूट्रिशन टू कीप द इम्यून सिस्टम इन अ हेल्दी स्टेट. मीन्स एज योर इम्यून सिस्टम इज पावरफुल then it can fight with the microbes and it can keep our body healthy. Okay, next question is, what is the mechanism of action of antibiotics? Means, you have to explain that how antibiotics work. So first we will mention that what is an antibiotic. So antibiotics are chemical substances obtained from some microbes which stop the growth of specific kind of pathogens. So it is obtained from such kind of microbes. Now how will it work? So they block certain biochemical pathways which are important for the life cycle of pathogen. So what they will do? They will block the biochemical pathways which are important for the pathogens, for the survival of the pathogens. So as the pathways will be blocked, as that chemical reaction will stop and it will not affect us longer time. For example, penicillin does not allow cell wall formation in some bacteria and it blocks the chemical reaction required for cell wall formation. So this is how the antibiotic works. Understood, dear students? Okay. So if you want to note down this all the questions, you can note down. Now in next video we'll continue with the next questions. Okay, till then prepare it. Have a great day ahead. Thank you. So here we are ending. In the next video we'll continue with another questions. Till then have a great day. Thank you. Okay.